back to your biology practical class. Today I will discuss another identification topic. Okay, so let me tell you the heading of the practical. So this is from the study or observation of the following, or you can call it spotting. Now what is the heading? That heading is that just a minute. Specimens or slides or models and identification with reasons. Bacteria. No, this one we have completed, right? Yes, this one we have completed. This one was the under the point 2. Now next practical is virtual specimens or slides or models and identifying features of amoeba, hydra, liver fluke, ascaris, leech, earthworm, prawn, silkworm, honeybee, snail, starfish, shark, rohu, frog, lizard, pigeon and rabbit. Okay, so we have to read about all these animals. Now I will show you some of them, and questions will be asked from them only. Okay, and you have to write down the characteristics of those organisms or animals, and you have to draw the diagram on the left side of the page or white page of your practical copy. Okay, so this is the practical from where we come to know about the different identifying characteristics in different animal kingdom. Already you have read in the theory portion in the animal kingdom chapter, and before that you have came to know that what are the different classifications were there. To first it was 2 kingdom, 3 kingdom, 4 kingdom. Nowadays we are accepting the 5 kingdom plus classification. And what are the those? Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae, Animalia. Okay, all these you have already read in the theory portion. Now today I will discuss about the kingdom Animalia. Okay, so what are the different forms comes under kingdom Animalia? So these phylums are Porifera, Nidaria, Platyhelminthes, Nemathelminthes, Annelida, Arthropoda, Mollusca, Echinodermata and Chordata. Okay, and these I have told you name of the some animals. These will come under these different phylum. Okay, so first I will show you some of the animals specimen, and after that I will tell you the characteristics of them. Okay, so first let me tell you that how you have to write it down. That first is aim will be that part which I have told you from the syllabus, and after that requirements. What are the requirements? Here we should take some fresh or preserved animal specimens. We have to take a record file. We have to take a pencil, eraser, sharpener, and a laboratory guide or practical book. These are the requirements. Now next step is the procedure. What is the procedure? So first you have to come in the laboratory room, and after that you have to listen carefully instructions provided by your teacher, and you have to note down the identifying characteristics, identifying features of those particular animals. And after that you have to study and observe the specimens or the slides very carefully, and you have to draw the diagram either directly from the specimen or slide, showing the all the details by taking appropriate scale of magnification. Okay, and you have to draw which is visible to you. Okay, do not sketch the elaborate diagram from the book. Draw only whatever you can see from the diagram. Okay, and you have to label the different diagrammatic part, different parts of the diagram symmetrically in the parallel lines. Okay, so this is the procedure for performing this practical. Now first I will discuss about the amoeba. Okay, so amoeba will come under the kingdom Protista, and the phylum is Protozoa. Okay, so you have seen the amoeba. So I will send you the picture of the amoeba in the assignment of your e-portal or my e-portal. Please check it, and I will also send the picture of all the specimens. Okay, in the assignment part you have to check it. also what is the location of the amoeba? Amoeba occurs in ponds, ditches, lakes, streams. Okay, where plenty of decaying organic matter is present. It is a unicellular organism, microscopic, grayish in color, and it is under the microscope. It appears a jelly-like substance. It is a irregular structure because, as you know, that it is having pseudopodia, and inside its body, food vacuoles, contractile vacuole, prominent nucleus is there, and this part is very important in identifying characteristics of amoeba. That outgrowths, small finger-like outgrowths are there, which are called as pseudopodia. Okay, and these are the organs of locomotion, and also pseudopodia helps in the capturing of the food. Okay. And amoeba shows holozoic mode of nutrition. It reproduces asexually by binary fission and multiple fission, and it passes unfavorable condition by forming a protective layer around it. So these are the different identifying characteristics of amoeba. Okay, and so if I consider the diagnostic feature, you have to write down those, that pseudopodia part, unicellular body, presence of contractile vacuole. These are diagnostic feature of amoeba. Next, I will come to the next one, that is Hydra. Okay, so Hydra will come under the kingdom Animalia, and the phylum is Cnidaria. And what are the different diagnostic feature of Hydra? Hydra is having soft body. It is a diploblastic animal. You know the meaning of diploblastic, triploblastic organism, and it is body. Their body is elongated, quite sac-like structure. They are having tentacles. Okay, so you can find the mouth, hypostome, tentacles, body. These parts can be found inside the Hydra, and small bud-like outgrowths can also be seen in case of Hydra. That means it is a mode of reproduction. Reproduction takes place in Hydra asexually by budding, and sometimes sexually by the gametes produced by the gonads. Okay, and their body is elongated, tube-like structure. They are at the opening. They are having mouth, and in the dilated region around the mouth, which is called as hypostome. Okay, this hypostome part is very important. Okay, and it can be found in the clear and cool freshwater ponds, pools, lakes, streams, etc. Okay, and sometimes it may be attached with the summer stones. Okay, and these are the main characteristics of Hydra. I will send you these two picture through the assignment, because these are microscopic. So I will not be able to show you here because you are not present here. So that's why I will send it through my assignment. Come to the next one. Next one is Fasciola hepatica. Common name is liver fluke. Next one is liver fluke. Scientific name is Fasciola hepatica. Its classification is kingdom Animalia, phylum Platyhelminthes. Now they are an endoparasite. This can be found in the bile duct of the sheep, goats, cattle, and sometimes other vertebrates, including human. Okay, and sometimes it causes serious liver disease called liver rot. That's why its common name is liver fluke. Okay, and it is somewhat triangular. It's a leaf-like structure they are having. It has a oral and ventral sucker, which is used to adhere to the bile duct as their parasite. And their body is covered by cuticle with spinules, and their body is sac-like, and they are having a blind sac-like body, and at the opening they are having a mouth, and they are usually hermaphrodite. So these are the main characteristics. So what are the different diagnostic characteristics? The body is triangular and leaf-like. Body is covered with cuticle and presence of two suckers. Okay, so let me tell you all the characteristics of all the animals, and after that I will show you. Okay, so next one is Ascaris. So Ascaris, its common name is roundworm, and full scientific name is Ascaris lumbricoides. Ascaris, Lumbricoides, and it also comes under the kingdom Animalia, and phylum is Nemathelmintha. Okay, so what are the diagnostic feature? It is a common intestinal parasite of man, especially this can be found in case of children. Occasionally it may occur in the intestine of pig, sheep, cattle, monkey, etc. Okay, and it is having a cylindrical body and both the ends are tapering. And the adult worms are sexually dimorphic, so males and females will find both the forms, and males are comparatively smaller than the females. Their posterior part is slightly curved, and males have two needle-like pinnae setae or copulatory setae which protrude out from the anus. So what are the diagnostic feature of Ascaris? They are endoparasite, their body is elongated with tapering ends, body is covered with cuticle, and mouth is guarded by three leaves. Okay, so these are the diagnostic feature of Ascaris. When I will show you, you will be able to find all this. Okay, now come to the next one, that is leech. Leech, the scientific name of leech is Hirudinaria granulosa. Hirudinaria granulosa is the scientific name of leech, and it also comes under kingdom Animalia, and phylum is Annelida. Now what is the location? It can be found in ponds, lakes, rivers, swamps, that means in the moist soils near such water bodies. Okay, they are also an previous to the endoparasite, this one is ectoparasites of cattle and other animals. It sucks blood by periodically coming in contact with the body of the host. Okay, you know the difference between ectoparasite and endoparasite. Ectoparasite means animals which are living outside the body of the host, and endoparasite means animals which are living inside the body of the host. Okay, so leeches are ectoparasites. Now their body is dorsoventrally flattened, measures about 15 cm length, but they can stretch their body up to 30 cm when required. It is usually olive green in color, and their body is segmented, and they are having a mouth surrounded by a cup-like anterior sucker, and leeches are hermaphrodite animal but shows cross-fertilization. Okay, and their posterior end bears also posterior suckers. Okay, so what are the diagnostic features? Their body is actually very slimy and elongated and segmented body, presence of anterior and posterior suckers. So these two are the main diagnostic feature of leech. Next one is earthworm. So what is the scientific name of earthworm? Ferritima posthuma. Ferritima posthuma is the scientific name of the earthworm, and this one also comes under the kingdom Animalia and phylum Annelida. What is the location of the earthworm? That earthworm live in burrows in moist soil where decaying vegetation and other organic matter is present. During rainy season, they come out of their burrows as the latter get flooded by water. Okay, so their body is long, cylindrical, segmented body. It measures about 10 to 20 centimeter in length, and it is also quite slimy in touch and pinkish brown in color. And their dorsal surface of the body is recognized by darker color, and ventral surface is marked by genital apertures. Okay, and they are having in their body segments on particularly 14th, 15th and 16th form a band like structure which is called as clitellum. Okay, mouth is present at the anterior end, and earthworm is hermaphrodite animal. Okay, so what are the different diagnostic features? First one, elongated cylindrical segmented body. Second one, presence of prostomium and clitellum. And third one is presence of CT for locomotion. Okay, so these are the diagnostic features. Means these features can be easily seen from the specimens. Now come to the next one. Next one is prawn. Prawn also comes under the kingdom Animalia, and the phylum is Arthropoda. Prawn can be found in the freshwater such as rivers, ponds, lakes, swamps. Their body is curved about 5 to 18 centimeter in length. Their cephalothorax is covered by a hard structure. You can see, you can find out, because all of you have touched the prawn. So their dorsal cephalothorax is covered by a hard structure which extends as a serrated process called rostrum. Okay, so I will show you which one is rostrum. And cephalothorax also bears 8 pairs of segmented legs on each of antenna and antennules, and stalked compound eyes are present. Okay, and abdomen also consists of 6 segments. Prawns are usually unisexual, that means male and female sex organ occur in separate individuals. So what are the diagnostic features of prawn? That is, they are brown in color, body spindle shaped, curved body, and cephalothorax is covered by a carapace with serrated rostrum, and abdomen is 6 segmented. Okay, so these are the identifying features of prawn. Now come to the next one, that is silkworm. Silkworm, kingdom Animalia, and scientific name of silkworm is Bombyx mori, phylum is Arthropoda. Okay, and what are the different features? That adult silk moth is about 2.5 centimeter long with 2 pairs of wings. It is creamy white in color. Their body is divisible into head, thorax, and abdomen, and it is covered with very minute scales. Okay. Silkworms are usually unisexual. Their life cycle, they are having different stages. Egg, larva, pupa, adult. These 4 stages can be found in their life cycle, and pupa hatches out into the adult moth. Okay, and the larva undergoes 4 molting and then stops feeding, and it secretes a sticky fluid through its spinnerets. So which on coming in contact with air becomes silk thread and remains wrapped around its body to form a pupa, and from the pupa we will get the adult one. Okay, so what are the diagnostic features? Body is divisible into head, thorax, and abdomen, presence of 2 pairs of wings and 3 pairs of legs, and larva form cocoon. Okay, these are the identifying features. Now come to the next one, that is honeybee. The scientific name of honeybee is Apis indica. It also comes under kingdom Animalia and phylum Arthropoda, class Insecta. What are the diagnostic features of honeybee? Presence of jointed appendages and 3 pairs of legs and 2 pairs of wings, and hind wings are smaller. Okay, so honeybee is a social insect and lives in a colony, showing great division of labor. 3 types of individuals can be found: queen, drones, and workers in their colony. Drones are males, and while the workers are sterile females, the queens lay eggs. Okay. The body of honeybee is divided into head, thorax, and abdomen, as they are coming under the group insect, okay, class Insecta. And thorax has 3 pairs of legs, 2 pairs of wings, and the mouth parts are modified for collecting the nectar from the pollen. Okay, so these are the identifying features of honeybee. Now come to the next one, that is snail. So what is the scientific name of snail? Phyla globosa, kingdom Animalia, and phyla Mollusca. And snails are commonly found in freshwater streams, ponds, ditches, lakes, etc. And it has a soft and slimy body enclosed in a coil calcareous cell. Their body is covered with a coil calcareous cell, and the opening of the cell is closed by a thick plate like operculum. Okay, and their body is differentiated to head, foot, visceral mass, and mantle. Head, foot, visceral mass, and mantle. Their body is divided into these 4, and sexes are separate with slight sexual dimorphism. The foot is anterior and ventral, sole like, used for creeping. Okay, so what are the different diagnostic features? Cell is univalve and coiled. foot muscular and broad and head distinct with eyes and tentacles. Tentacles are also present in their head. Okay. Now come to the next one, that is starfish. So what is the scientific name of starfish? Is Asterius. Okay. And kingdom Animalia and phylum is Echinodermata. So they are usually marine. They are found crawling on rocky sea bottom in shallow water. Their body is flatty and star-shaped with pentamerous symmetry. They are having a small central disc-like structure. And their oral surface is directed downwards and bears pentagonal mouth in the central disc, and aboral surface bears large number of short and movable spines. Anus is present in the center of the disc. A narrow umbilical groove is present, which extends from each angle of the mouth along the midline of the oral surface of each arm. Okay, and their sexes are separate without sexual dimorphism. So what are the diagnostic features? Their body is pentagonal and star shaped. You can see it very easily. And oral and aboral surfaces are quite distinct. And each arm with four rows of tube feet. They are having a structure which is called as, they are having some projections. That means from each umbilical groove contains on either side two rows of tubular projections called tube feet or podia. Okay, and this is helping in the water vascular system and locomotion, food capture and respiration. So these are the identifying features or diagnostic feature of starfish. Now the last one is shark. Okay, so shark, its scientific name is Coleodon, kingdom Animalia, phylum Chordata. So shark is the another name is they are having, that is dogfish. It is somewhat laterally compressed and spindle shaped or streamlined body with pointed snout. The body is differentiated into head, trunk and tail. And the head is dorsoventrally compressed, which ventrally bears semicircular mouth and two mid dorsal, one mid ventral, one caudal, two pairs of lateral fins are present for swimming. Sexes are separate. Males have claspers in pelvic region. These are the copulatory organs. And sharks are viviparous. That means you can call it that they can give the young ones. Okay. So these are the different features of different animals of different phyla under kingdom Animalia. Okay. So you have to write down the characteristics of each of them in your practical copy. You have to write it down from the book. Just write down the identifying features. No need of writing all the features, whichever you can be able to see. Just write down those identifying features, and in the back side white page you have to draw the diagram of this particular animal. Okay, now I will show you one by one. Okay, so this is the honeybee. There you can find the different stages. So first, egg, larva, pupa, then queen, adult queen, worker, drone. These three are adult. Okay, so now you can identify the honeybee. Clear? Come to the next one, snail. You can find the calcareous covering. So this is the snail. Earthworm. You can find the segmented body. Earthworm. Silkworm. Prawn. So this part is the rostrum. Starfish. Just write it down right now. After finishing all the practicals, you have to submit. Okay. I will inform all of you when you have to submit your practical copy. Liver fluke. Fasciola hepatica, liver fluke. Ascaris female. Ascaris male. Okay. So, just write it down. Write down so you can see all the specimens are there. On your exam day, you have to find out which animal is this, and you have to draw the diagram, label diagram, and you have to write down 3 to 4 minimum 3 to 4 diagnostic features. Okay. So everyone, please write it down in your practical copy. So for today, that's it. Thank you and bye bye everyone.